Okay, so now we're going to talk about the different ways people try to balance what they're giving in a relationship and what they're getting in a relationship. So one thing people try to do is they try to maximize their gain and minimize their loss. So, for example, if there is something that you can do for your teacher to help your teacher, you might help your teacher more than a fellow student. Because you'll feel like, well, maybe my teacher will be nice and kind of give me an extra few points on something. And whereas a fellow student can't necessarily do that. So that kind of relationship might be governed by social exchange, where you're looking for a relationship where you can get the most out of what you're going to be giving. However, equity theory says that the best relationships are when both people feel like they're investing equal amounts. So here we have this relationship that's governed by social exchange, but equity theory says that you should be receiving about as much as you're giving, and so should your partner. So you should both feel like you're kind of putting in and getting out similar amounts, and that those will be the most successful relationships. And there are two different ways to try and make things equitable. The first is an exchange relationship. And in an exchange relationship, people are making sure that the other person is putting in exactly as much as they are. So we have two people who live together, Jason and Alex. Jason does 60 minutes of housework and Alex does 60 minutes of housework. Jason puts the dishes in the sink. Alex puts the dishes in the dishwasher. Jason pays for utilities. Alex pays rent. So you have these two people who are being very careful that they're both doing kind of the exact same amounts. And that would be an exchange relationship where it's very much you're keeping track of how much each person is doing to make sure that you're both equal. Conversely, there are communal relationships where it's not always perfectly equitable, but both people's needs end up addressed. So, for example, Jason was having a bad day, so Alex cooked dinner. And then another day, Alex's car broke down, so Jason took him to work. So they're not necessarily doing the same things for each other, but when they have needs, the other person is trying to address those needs to make sure that each person is benefiting from the relationship. So a communal relationship isn't necessarily about I do this, you do this, and we kind of move down the list, but it's about generally I'm trying to look out for you and you're trying to look out for me.